Good morning. What did God show his prophet? Today we're at Jeremiah 11, verses 18 to 23. Now the Lord gave me knowledge of it, and I know it, for you showed me their doings. But I was like a docile lamb brought to the slaughter, and I did not know that they had devised schemes against me, saying, let us destroy the tree with its fruit, and let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name may be remembered no more. But, O Lord of hosts, you who judge righteously, testing the mind and the heart, let me see your vengeance on them, for to you I have revealed my cause. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the men of Anathoth who seek your life, saying, do not prophesy in the name of the Lord, lest you die by our hand. Therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, behold, I will punish them. The young men shall die by the sword, their sons and their daughters shall die by famine, and there shall be no remnant of them, for I will bring catastrophe on the men of Anathoth, even the year of their punishment. They were planning to kill Jeremiah, and God wanted him to know it. He knew they were given over to evil desires, but he hadn't realized they'd gone this far. His reaction? Well, not really to plot their destruction, but to ask God to stop them. Even maybe boomerang their own plot back upon themselves and kill them. They were planning to kill him. But it's interesting, as he gets into the prayer here, what does he do? He starts by talking about, God, you judge righteously, you judge the mind and the heart. Jeremiah knows that God tests us. He looks at our decisions. He reminds God that, I know you're judging my thoughts. I surrender all my thoughts to you. I want you to evaluate and correct any wrong thinking that I might have. And you know, it's true. Every thought is a test. Every action is a revelation of what we are, of who we are. And God's answer is that he will indeed punish them. They're not really plotting against Jeremiah. They're plotting against God. Because when you try to close the mouth of God's prophet, you're plotting against God. And today, even if we try to make the testimony of the Spirit of God of none effect, if we try to not listen to his prophets, we're trying to close the mouth of God, and I wouldn't try that if I were you. When you're attempting to close the mouth of God's faithful service, you're plotting against God himself. In the book of Romans chapter 1, we find that God's wrath is revealed from heaven against those who try to suppress the truth in unrighteousness, which is certainly what anybody's doing who's trying to suppress God's speaking through his servants, the prophets, to us. Now, Jeremiah's hometown of Anathoth was just a few miles from Jerusalem, and when the invading armies would come in from the north and lay siege to Jerusalem and devastate everything, Anathoth was right there in the neighborhood. So we know that this same judgment was going to come to those people in Anathoth. When you or I have thoughts of vengeance, as I think Jeremiah did when he found out they were trying to kill him, we should submit those thoughts to God. Vengeance is his, he says. God can show us that our thoughts are wrong, that our judgments are wrong, or, you know, he can carry out the vengeance himself. He knows our hearts better than we do. You know, Hollywood movies put us in our own hands. The action hero leaps out and fixes everything, saves the day. But the Bible reminds us to put ourselves in the hands that were nailed to the cross. There is more compassion in those hands than in our hands. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, help us to be right. Help us not to be passive and just fall over when things come our way. But Lord, show us what actions to take. We should be an active people, but we shouldn't be seeking vengeance. Our victories, our corrective actions, they're all in your hands, Lord. We want them to be consonant with heaven. We want them to be things that you can approve of and that please you. So Lord, bless your people. Help us. We are in a time when there are terrible inroads against truth in your church, terrible inroads from the culture, and it's just raining down upon us. And what will we do? Sit by and just let everything good be washed away? No, I don't think so. But Lord, you show us what to do. May we not take one step ahead of your leading and not be one step behind your leading. Lord, may our hearts be surrendered to you and you just show us step by step. That's all we ask. Thank you for hearing our prayer, Lord. We ask for this help from you in Jesus' name. Amen. We're certainly not to be passive doormats. We're to surrender our action hero impulses to God, and he'll show us what to do. So God be with you today in his world.